This is what we're doing today. An app that loads pictures from the internet and grabs colors from those images to compose the UI theme. I'll first show a simple method with no dependencies. It returns a single color that represents the average for all the pixels. From this color, we can create variations to use on different parts of our interface. Then we'll see how to use an external package that can give us several color options. We can't just throw those colors and expect the UI to look good, so we also manipulate the palette to ensure good readability. This is the app I have prepared beforehand, with no colors. It loads a random list of images from Lottery Pixen, and if we tap a picture, it will expand it and show some details, a share button, and a place for the text that we want to make sure it's readable. In the description, you can find the source for both the finished project and the version you see now. The first thing we have to do is replace the sync image. When it finishes loading, what it gives us is a view, but we need access to the bitmap, so let's create our own loader. In the service that already exists for loading the list, we add a function to download the data and return a UI image. Let's create the observable objects that will hold the image and the loading status. Now we can create the view that will replace a sync image. We just need the photo ID instead of a URL. At content view, we can replace the component and it should show the images just as before. The difference is that now we have access to the image in our loader to grab the colors. I'll create a new file for that and set the struct for our color theme. It will have a single color for now. To get this color, we'll create a function that will apply the CI area average filter. It expects the input as a CI image, so we convert the one we have in the vector for the area where the filter should be applied. In our case, the whole image. The result for the filter is a single pixel image that we can extract the red, green, and blue values to create the color. We can now create a public function to generate the theme from the image, then add the theme to the image loader, and send it to our custom async image content. Now we can use the average color as the background for the thumbnails. Alright, our grid is a lot more colorful now, but the text is quite hard to see when the image is dark. Let's see how we can find the right color for each case. So at color theme, we add a new color that I will call contrasting tone, and it will be black if the color is light, otherwise it will be white. Now, how do we know if a color is light? It's quite simple, converting it to grayscale. The method is a bit weird because it comes from the Objective-C era, so we have to create a few variables that will get mutated. Then we check if the white value is more than half. Now we can use the contrasting tone in our view and check the results. Nice, now the text is visible, no matter what background it's in. But we can do better and add a little hint from the original color with the help of HSB. The HSB is an alternative way of representing the RGB color mode. So instead of values for red, green, and blue, we define the color by hue, the angle on the color wheel. Starting from pure red, it moves towards green, blue, and back to red. Saturation sets how vivid is the color. As it gets lower, it tends to the grayscale. Brightness sounds obvious, but it can be confusing. Zero brightness is black, as expected. But some might think that full brightness would be white, when it's actually just the pure color. To get white, we also need to reduce the saturation. Now, let's say this is the average color that we got from an image. To get a darker version of this color, all we have to do is reduce the brightness. For a lighter color, we crank up the brightness and turn down the saturation. So let's do that in code. The method to get the HSB values is similar to the getWhite we used before, so I'll create the required variables and point it to getHue. Now we create the contrasting tone, so for the dark one, I'll set the saturation for almost the maximum and the brightness to almost the minimum. For the light tone, we want to ensure the saturation would be greater than the original, in case of a grayscale image. The change is subtle, but it helps the app feel harmonious. And now that we know how to create color variations, it's time to give color to the details view. So the selected picture tuple will now include the color theme, and we can use the contrasting tone in the back bottom and the shadow. The background will be the average color. Then if we send the theme from our grid, the details view should show these colors. Now, let's create the colors for the texts and the bottom. I'll give some fixed values and apply to the view so we can see the changes as we work on each color. the body text color and background will swap according to the device color scheme. I will pass the theme to our CTA view. Now I'll ping the preview with both modes side by side and get back to our color theme. Because we have control on both of the body colors, we don't need to push them to the extremes as we did to the contrasting tone. We're gonna play with the hue for the CTA and push it slightly, using truncating remainder to ensure it will stay in range. Then push the saturation and brightness, always making sure it won't get too high. We get the label contrast color the same way we did before. The alpha should always be 1 for our case, so I'll just reuse the old variable. Let's see what we got so far. Nice, the colors change according to the pictures, and the texts are always readable in light and dark mode. We can do even better, but if you like it so far, it will be awesome if you give this video a thumbs up. This way, YouTube will recommend it to more people. Thank you. Now, this method will work great for most cases, but the colors in some photos may cancel each other, and the average can end up as gray or brown. That's when this package palette comes to the rescue. It will scan the bitmap and try to pick 6 colors that vary in brightness and saturation. So I'll add the package by pasting the URL for the GitHub repository. I'm using this fork I made that adds support for the Swift Package Manager and for Async Await. You can find the link for the original and my fork in the description. We can now import it and create a palette in our theme. I'll separate the code below to a new function so we can add an async version for the generator. We use the async version in the image loader and the synchronous one in the preview. I'll add one less property to our theme that will hold all colors. And quickly make a view for us to check the colors selected by the package. Some pictures won't have as many colors as others. A black and white image can't have vibrant colors, for example, so we have to account for that in our theme. So the body colors will be based on the muted ones, falling back to the average color. I'll also tweak the values a little bit. You can play with the numbers and find what works best for your app. The CTA is very simple. We use the vibrant colors. As a last resource, we keep the color created from the average. The label color is already set to work with any color the button has, so no change here. The app gets to a new level with more colors. And looks great on dark mode too. If you would like to see more experience in SwiftUI, take a look at my previous video, where I make an audio visualizer with the new Swift Charts framework. Thank you for watching.